Welcome students, this is a web designing class and this is a day 3. In previous class we have already done the what tool we have to use for web designing in computer and mobile device, and in the second we have to and how can you plan steps for web designing. In this class day 3 we trying to implementation of our planning. Okay, so first I'm taking a one example that through this example we will see that how can we plan a small website and how can we try to code a particular page in HTML. So I'm opening a normally software. For example, I open MS Paint because this is a normally software. So in this software I'm using a blog. This is for home page. Okay, so I type here home. So this is my home page. Second page is about us. I enter the text here, about us. This is a about us page. Now create one more page here, that is contact us. Type here contact us. So we have a three page. First is home page, second is about us, and third is contact us. So I want to link all the page. For example, from home I want to link about us, and here home page I want to link contact us. So I have a three pages and I link these three pages each other. ठीक है, एक दूसरे से ये connected है. This is a site map. अब site map जब हमने बना लिया तो अब हमें इन तीन पेजों के लिए क्या करना पड़ेगा, एक वायरफ्रेम क्रिएट करना पड़ेगा. ओके, तो वायरफ्रेम में हम ये चाहते हैं कि किस किस तरीके से हम वायरफ्रेम क्रिएट कर सकते हैं. सबसे पहले फॉर द होम पेज, मैं होम पेज के लिए वायरफ्रेम क्रिएट करना चाहता हूँ. आई कैन ड्रॉ दिस मॉडल ऑन द पेपर एंड ऑल्सो एनी सॉफ्टवेयर. हम किसी भी सॉफ्टवेयर में बना सकते हैं. वी हैव क्रिएट साइट मैप एंड नाउ I want to create a wireframe for this home page. So today I will apply basic tags on this home page. So first I have to create a simple home page. So I am drawing here. For example, this is our page. Okay. Now here I want to type my site name. For example, I type here website. Okay. So this is my website name. Now. And I want to draw a horizontal line here. So I draw a horizontal line. I want to insert image. So here I am creating a block for insert a image. Okay, like this. Now here I want to type any kind of text. I think I should increase this image size. So I increase the image size like here. Okay, this is my image. So I type here, this is my image. So we will insert image here. But we forgot one thing. I have forget to create a menu bar. Okay, so I want to create a menu bar also. So where I want to create, so I drag this image below here, and now I want to create a menu bar. I create a block or I directly write here menu. For example, we want to create three pages. First is home page, home. Okay, second is about us, and third is contact us. Now I reduce the size. I maintain some gap here for the menus. I have created three menus. Now these are my menus. Here is my image, and below the image I can put the any kind of content. I am creating a block for inserting a text. So here I will insert my text, any kind of text. Okay, my text goes here. Okay, so now here we will be enter our text. Now I want to create this page. One more thing I want to add, footer. So for footer I am inserting a one more block here. like that. And here I will be insert footer like copyright and other options. I type here, this is footer. We will insert here copyright and etc. thing. So this is a wireframe for my home page. Now I want to create this kind of page in HTML. Phone, we have a many apps in mobile phone for drawing, so you can easily draw this kind of a structure. So we called it wireframe. Now I want to create a similar design in HTML page. So let's start. How can we design this page? First, I open to Notepad++. I'll click open here. This is the Notepad, and now I want to create this kind of structure. So I need an image and many content. We need a place where we can put our file. So first we have to create a place for website. Okay, so I create a folder. For example, I open any destination. Okay, I will store all the file of my website in this folder, and now open it. We have to create three more folder. First is I want to create image. For images, we will put all images in this folder. Okay, now second folder we have to create of CSS. We will put CSS file here. We discuss later about this section. Now third more folder we have create JS, it for JavaScript. Okay, we put our JavaScript here. Now I have created three folders. First is CSS, second is image, and third is JS. Okay, so we have three folders. Now I want to create a file here. So go to your Notepad++. Okay, and now I type some basic structure of HTML. HTML head, title, and I put here home page. Okay, so this is my home page. This is head. I'll close it. Now we want to close this HTML also, so, but before we have to start a body tag. We will write all the stuff here in body. It will show on the our web page. Body, close the HTML. Now save it. Select your location. I want to search my location, so my location I know where is. So I am searching for it, and this is my folder. And now I go three folders here in this location. I will store this file, and I name this file is home.stm. So this is the extension name of .stm of HTML file. If you want to create a HTML file, so you have to add this extension with the file name. Okay, now click on save. So you can see file is saved. Check in our folder, you can see a home.html file is stored here. Now if I run here, so you can see here is nothing, but here is title is showing home page. Why this is showing? Because I enter here, if I change the title here, for example, this is my first HTML page. Okay, when I save here in the title and go to this web browser, now this is my file home.html. you can see home page is showing here. Now I refresh it, so what I enter in the title, the title show on the top on the tab. Okay, now you can see this is my file first HTML page. Now where we set in the title, if I change the title, so you can see header will change automatically, like home. Now I type the home here, and now goes to this web browser, and now refresh it. Now click on this icon, you can see here home. So title show here on the tab. Now what is next? You can run your file directly here on the click on the run option. Now click on run option, and here some option for launch in Firefox, launch in Internet Explorer. I stand for इंटरनेट एक्सप्लोरर, लॉन्च इन क्रोम, लॉन्च इन सफारी. सो दीज आर द वेब ब्राउजर्स. ओके, सो नाउ आई एम यूजिंग द फायरफॉक्स. क्लिक ऑन फायरफॉक्स. No problem. Now run this file, go to run and click on launch in Chrome. So this file open with Google Chrome. Okay, our file is open. You can see this is our title of the HTML page. And now this is the file location of our HTML page, but here is nothing is here to view because we have not entered anything here. So first we have to create some kind of stuff here, for example body. So I create this is my first HTML page. Okay, now save is. And now I close this Google Chrome because I am running directly here. Run, click on run option and click on launch in Chrome. So you can see this is my first HTML page message is showing on the page. Here is some small thing about the HTML. For example, first thing is if I put many space here, one more than one, so you can see it will accept only one space. Okay, I save it and now I launch it. I save it and now I launch it on Google Chrome. Now you can see it is accepting only one space, it is not accepting one more spaces, but here I have entered many spaces, but it will accept only one space. So now time to starting the tags. So I share a HTML file in your class. So first review the HTML file and by this file we can do some tag apply here. So how can we apply the tag? So I'm starting with paragraph tag. This is paragraph tag and why we use for writing a paragraph. Okay, for example I type any text, for example this is my text. Okay, and this is this, so I save it. Now I run it, so you can see I type these many lines in new line, but it is not starting with the proper line, it is continuing, it is starting continuing. Okay, so I want to separate this line, so what can I do? I can use for paragraph tag for this paragraph. Okay, I use P for paragraph and now I close it. Okay, so now run this file, click on launch in Chrome. You can see it is showing first paragraph in other line. So by this way we can create a paragraph through the paragraph tag. Okay, now this is a paragraph tag. Now I want to create a heading. So we have six type of headings, start with h1 and end with h6. For example h1 and close this tag like here h1. Second is h2 and close h2. So similarly we have tag heading tag from H3, H4, and H5, and finally I have created H6. So these are the six headings. So here I enter a heading, my website name with H1 tag. You can see, if I run this file in Chrome, so this is the heading 1 showing in the bold and size in bigger size. Okay, now I want to enter text in heading 2. So similarly, I copy this text and now I put this text into the S2 headings. So here I write website name with S2 tag. You can see what happened. Okay, so text size is reduced. You can see in H1 we have a bigger size, and instead of H1 we have in S2 is size is less than H1. So when we use the tag S2, S3, H4, so it will reduce the size of the text. Okay. Now what about the H3? Now I copy text here, website name with H3, and now you can see text size is reduced. You can see in bigger size in H1. After the H1 we use S2 and S3, so continuously size is reducing. Okay, when we use S6, so text size is got more lesser than other headings. Now for example, I put here with H4, H5 and H6. Okay, now save it and run. Now you can compare the size of the alt text. This is the over heading 1. You can see this is the large in the size. After the H1, we use the tag S2, S3, H4, H5 and S6. So you are seeing that size is continuously reducing after the H1. So if you use the tag S2, S3, H4, so size is continuously reduced. And for big size, we will use H1 for heading 1. So now this is over heading 6. Now by this way we can create our headings. Okay, now we have already used the paragraph tag. This is our paragraph tag. Now I want to type some text. We are discussing some formatting tags like bold, italic, underline. Okay, so the quick brown fox jumps over the lazy dog. Now I save it and I refresh it. You can see the quick brown fox jumps over the lazy dog is showing here. Okay, now I want to bold this brown word. So what tag should I use? So I can use bold. For bold we use B, and now close this tag like here. Okay, now refresh it. You can see brown is bold. What happen if you don't close this tag? If I remove, so you can see after the starting the bold tag, if you do not close this text, so all the text getting bold. But we don't wanna bold all the text, we want to bold only this brown word. Okay, so we have to close this tag here. So I close this. Now refresh it. You can see only brown word is bold. Now I want to make italic this jump word. So what can I use for this? For jumps word, I want to make italic, so I use I tag for italic. Okay, now start here and close this tag here. Now save it. Okay, now go to this page and now refresh it. You can see that jump is getting italic. Now you want to underline this lazy word or lazy dog. Okay, so similarly you can expect what I am going to use. I am using U for underline. Okay, now close this tag. Similarly, we are using in Open Office and MS Word bold, italic, underline. Three same thing is here. We make bold the text, we make the italic, and we also make the text underline. Okay, so for bold we are using B, for italic we are using I, and for underline we are using U. Now save it and now refresh it. You can see the lazy dog is underlined. Okay, so this is a formatting tag. By this tag we can make underline all the text. Now here is some text, so I am starting to designing my page like this. So we will use some tags here. So I have shared PDF already. You will find all the tag that I use in this creating this page that I use. Their reference available in this PDF. You can see and read the reference. So I am starting directly design this page. Okay, so this is my wireframe, and now I want to create this kind of page. So let's start. So I close everything. Okay, so this is my home page, and now I remove it. Now start with designing the page. Okay, so now this is my page. Okay, now I want to create this kind of page. So what can I do? Now first we want to enter the website name here. So here I am using h1 for website name. Okay, website. Okay, this is my website. Now I want to create this kind of horizontal line. Okay, so I will use HR tag for horizontal line. Okay, so this is the way. This is a self close tag, so because of this reason I use directly. You can use this tag also like this, no problem, but it doesn't mean. So I am directly using, this is self closing tag, so I am using this way. Now I want to create home, about us, and contact us. Okay, so I am typing text in paragraph, and I am form space about us space and contact us. Okay, now close this. Now below we want to insert an image. Okay, so I put img, I put img src tag here. Okay, so this tag we use for inserting an image in our page, and src means source. We set the source of file, but that where is our file. So I adding tag only after downloading an image I will insert. Now for here I want to create some kind of tag, so I create a paragraph. Okay, for here is my text. Okay, now time to creating the footer. Okay, so for header we have some special tag in HTML 5 like header. So I put tag still here in header section. Okay, So this is considered as a header. This is our image, and now I want to create footer. So I put this text in footer. Sorry. So I want to create the footer. So below, I enter the footer. Now I enter the text here in paragraph that this is my footer. Okay. Now let's check. Run this page. Okay. Now click on this and launch in Google Chrome. So you can see it is not similar like that. Only top side text is showing like similar, but here is there is no gap in menus, and here is image is not showing here. So first we are putting the image in this page. Okay, so first we download the image for our website. So I am searching a web image here. Now Google, and I search the image for my background for website background. You can see here some images is here. So I select first I browse all the images. After I will select the image. For example, I take this kind of image. Okay, now I click on it. Okay, I want to download this image. So right click on this and click on here is no view image option. Okay, so open a new tab. You can see, and now right click and save as a image. So I want to save this image where that I have created a folder in my website. So find your website folder. Where is it? Where is it? Now my folder here, test in website. Now we have created the image folder. Put your image here. Now I change the name, for example img1. Okay, and this image extension you can see .jpg. This is a .jpg image. Now save it. Now you can check this image in your folder. Now this is our folder, and you can check this is my image, image name .img.jpg. Now I want to insert this image in my page. Okay, where? Here. Okay, so my file is here. You can see my file is here. This is my home file, and I want to tell you this file that you have to go first in this image folder, and here you will be find this image one file. So how can tell this file that you have to go in this folder? So this folder name is image. Okay, so I tell it first you have to go to into image. Now slash, now you have to open this image img1.jpg. okay, so I again tell him after going to image folder, now what you have to open? You have to open img1.jpg file. Okay, now save it and now run it. We can see a image is appear here, but it is not a look like this. Okay, it is not completely looking like that, but we will still working on it now. So I have insert image. So these are my menus. Okay, and this is my image, this is my text, and this is my footer. Okay, so let's start design like that. Okay, so how can we design? So first I am designing to try this website text. So I am introducing the concept of classes. Okay, so here I am using one more tag is style. Okay, now what you have to do, we will create some classes. So how can you create a class? If you want to create a classes, so use dot. Okay, after putting the dot, you have to enter your class name. For example, I want to create a class for my this header, this website. Okay, so now I use web name. Okay, now use parenthesis, use curly braces and save it. Now, so how can I use this class for this? So I using heading one tag. So I want to use this class for this website. So what I have to do, I will use special attribute. I will use special attribute. The name is class. Okay. And now in this class, you will put this name here. Okay. So we have not used to this dot because we use this dot to create a class, but we have already created. So I am copy this name and now I am putting here. Okay. Now paste here. So I am nothing right here. So open our web browser. Okay. Now, so for example, I want to put color on this text. So what color I want to put? So I want to put here yellow color. So I have to write color yellow. Now use semicolon. Save it and refresh this page. Now you can see color is changed into yellow. Okay. Now I want to set a background color for this. Okay. So what background I want to need? I want. So I want background color. First we put black color. Okay. Now save it. Now you can see we have applied background color. Okay. For this text. Now you can see some margin is here. So I want to don't wanna this unnecessary space here. So this is the margin. Okay, so I am reducing the margin. To use margin tag is here, margin attribute here. I want to put margin 0 pixel. Okay, now save it and now refresh it. So this is the margin of body. I'm creating some style for body, this body. Okay, because I got this unnecessary space around this tag. I create some property for body. So here is margin equals to 0 pixels. Now refresh it. You can see here is margin is wiped out. Okay, margin is reduced. So by this way we can reduce all the margin. I want to put some space here because it is too congested. Okay, so I want to put some space here in this background black color and this text. Okay, so I have to use one more property here is padding. Okay, padding I use 10 pixels and save it. Now when I refresh it, you can see we got some space for here. Now so you can see I create the this kind of website text here. Now we have to create this kind of text here, about us, contact us. Okay, so now okay, so we will use a list for creating this kind of stuff. Go to your menus. These are our menus. Okay, so I'm creating a list. Okay, this is li. Okay, I want to put these three items here. For example, in list, first is our home. Okay, now second we want to put about us here, li about us. And now finally we need third item is contact us. Okay, contact us. Now save it and refresh it. You will get this kind of list, home, about us and contact us. Now we want to convert this item like these menus. Okay, so first I remove these menus here. Now, remove this paragraph tag from here. Okay. So this is UL. Now, I am creating a class for these menus. Here is menu class. Okay. I create a menu class. Using this class here. Class menu. Okay. Now save it. Okay. So here is nothing change here. So what we have to do now? First, we have to remove these unnecessary symbols from here. These three dots. So use here list style is none. So when I use this property and refresh it, you can see three dots are removed here. Okay. Now dot menu dot li, we are using this property for this li. Okay, we are using this I am creating property for this li. Okay, so I use li here, and now put the curly braces here, and now you can put here for example display inline. Okay, now semicolon here, so you can see it will be display inline. Okay, so these menus are inline. I want to put some space among them. So what can I use? So I can use padding also and margin also. So I am using padding is equals to 10px. Now save it and now refresh it. You can see we got some space between them. Okay, simply we have created the menus. What about this image? So I want to put this image on the screen full size. I want to this image till this screen. Okay, so what we have to do? So now I'm creating another class for image dot i1. Now here I'm set up the width for image is 100%. Now save it and use this class into this img. Okay, class equals to i1. Now save it and now go to your HTML page and refresh it. You can see image automatically adjust according to size. So now here we have applied the text width on the image. You can see image is here. Now this is our text. Okay, this is my text. Now we want to create a block here, some kind of this block. You can see we have create this website and this horizontal line and these menus. Now I have also put this kind of image and I want to create this kind of a block and I want to put text here. So what can I do for putting this box here? Now we will use one more tag here. Okay, what is the tag we have to use? So I am using div tag. Okay, div, it means division. So I use division tag here. Now, so this is my text. Now what I have to do? So I have creating a new class for this content. So I use t1 class. Okay, so put dot here and t1 here, and now so we want to like border here and size we want to 100%. Okay, so we can put the size also here. First I use the width, but before I want to use the width, I want to put color on the background of this div. So I am setting the background color. Okay, so I am putting any one color, for example general color, for example green color. First apply this tag, apply this class on this div tag. very similar, use class equals to t1 and now save it. Okay, run this browser. You can see we got green color here, but this is not a proper way. We want to need some width also here, and text, you can see here is not a gap in this text and in this border. So what we have to do, first we will change the color of this text. So I put here color is white. Now you can see when I refresh, so color is changed into the white. Now I want to put some space between the border and this text, so I am using again padding is 10 pixels. You can use 5 pixels, 20 pixels, it is your idea that what you want. Now click on, so you can see we got the some space here, but now I want to increase tab. So what I do, I will use height. Now I use 400 pixels for height. So when I refresh, you can see the height is increased. Okay, so we have increased the height. Now you can see this is my website name, these are my menus, this is my image, this is area for my text, and this is my footer. So we have created this kind of image, you can see.